Hi guys and gals, this is NovaCookie232 and welcome to day one of the MHC 2015 December challenge. The challenge of this month is Trapped in the Nether. There's been some changes in the standard rules, so I'm going to explain, and I've got to explain the actual objective and rules of this month. But I'll go through what the world will be set to. As you can see, that's version 2. Because I almost got day one right, almost, but didn't quite get there. I failed that attempt, so I'm going to do it again. It was ambiguous, but I decided that I wanted to do it again. And there wasn't really a thing that I could continue doing it. But, and I'll explain it well after I explain the rules. But the seed must be 2184. Generate structures are on. Large biomes are the world type, and allow cheats are off. So the rules, standard rules are no skipping the night, no harming passive mobs, drop some legal deaths that's not by you and such, maybe use some feathers and such, no eating meat from passive mobs except from but you can eat meat, can eat zombie flesh, and you can eat fish, which is great. Brightness set to 100% in options. No AFK crop growth or AFK mob grinding, etc, etc. Makes sense. No duplicate world info. So you can look and pick at people's world, like days, episodes, but you can't then look at the world beforehand. Everything on camera at normal speed. Episode runs sun up 20 minutes. That's about. Post episodes every Monday to Friday or earlier than that. A day earlier. No one dies on episode 1. And restoring of any backup is forbidden. You can't restore any backup if you die for any reason. No violent. So that's all of the rules for me. The objective of Trapped in the Nether is first you need to raid the village. Then we gather supplies, get to the Nether. By the end of the first episode or restarts, once in the Nether, without delay, mine the portal block and throw them and a diamond pick into the lava. Once trapped in Nether, survive and thrive. So, I'll point out that the reason I had to redo this is because I didn't. When I did go into when I was the end of day one, I didn't actually build the Nether to get to build the Nether portal because I was at my tent. I was mining my 10th obsidian block. It was actually funny. I was mining my 10th obsidian block as it was day one. So I don't count that as. I've done that day one correctly. So, I'm going to go into the chests, get the stuff, get from your chests. And I'm going to go straight off, because I know a little bit about it already now. And it makes sense why this challenge is what this challenge is. So, there's some lava over there. There's a lava pool. That is needed. There's some mushrooms and some brown mushrooms around there. And there's a ravine right there. You'll see it as we go past or go over it. And that is the ravine where we get all our stuff from. Hopefully we get this done a lot faster because this is all in a centralized area. There we go. There's a ravine. So, first things first. We hit trees multiple times. Get wood, etc, etc. So I'm going to get 3 pieces of wood, get a pickaxe, or going to get straight away make a diamond pickaxe. Because there's no point otherwise. We're only going to use it for the time in which we're in the overworld, which is only one day. Okay. Oh well, I'm going to go ahead and just take the liberty of mining the quarry blocks. The blocks we get in the ravine, because it just helps us go down to ravine. I'm gonna do that. It makes it easier for me to travel down. That's what I'm gonna do anyway. I'll loop back around. I think I'll go back up once I hit a point where I can go back up. Every ore is very, very needed. massively needed. I think the first mistake I made was getting obsidian till later, which is actually a terrible idea, because you get lots and lots of mobs trying to attack you. If you didn't already realize that, or if I was just being stupid, I was probably just being very stupid. Oh, hello, bat. I don't mind bats, they're pretty cool things personally. So that skeleton's over there. I'm going to ignore it and focus on things that matter to me. Like collecting enough iron to straight away smelt for... Oh, okay. So this skeleton seems to matter to me. And this zombie seems to matter to me. I don't care about it, but it was attacking me, so yeah. I need to get this this cobblestone furnace up quickly. Smelting enough for buckets. There is some coal in here, I'm pretty sure. I don't know where the coal is. Oh, well, there's some more iron. There we go. Okay. There's some iron. That should be quite a bit of iron. Currently, we've got some coal up there that we're going to need to mine back up. Time is of the essence. It definitely is. There is not a lot of time in this challenge to start with. But after that, you have all the time in the world to die. So yes. If you wondered why I haven't ransacked the village yet, this is because thinking about it clearly, you can't actually grow crops in the village. Oh, there's some iron down there. You can't actually grow crops in Nether, sorry. Therefore, it means it's pointless actually growing crops in the Nether, in it getting seeds. That is why I decided to completely wait for it to grow completely. Okay, getting this coal. Coal will be very important for the very start. After that, it's just any light source we can get. We can even use lava if we need to, and glowstone and such. But for the start, coal is useful. Gotta pay attention though, the Nether is not hospitable in the terms of actually having materials to survive and thrive on. Therefore you have to get as much as you can beforehand. Because there is mushrooms, which as long as you have some wood for a wooden bowl, it's fine. That you can survive on that, but other than that, there is not much else. Okay. I'm gonna be a daredevil here. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna get this. I'm not gonna get coal. Screw that. Okay, get this and get this. 28 iron plus whatever this amount of iron is. And then I'm literally gonna mine Lurdpole up away from this situation. Oh no. Why are you here? I always say that to mobs. Why are you even here? Just don't try. Go away. Go back another day. A day where you possibly might win. Okay. Oh, brief. Okay, we're ahead of I'm ahead of myself previously. I was nowhere near this point. I have all the stuff. Now it's time for me to go back up, light up the area around the lava, because we need to, trust me, we need to. I know lava's already lit up, but around the area you're going to be operating in, probably a great idea to light up, because lots of mobs spawn in fields, lots of mobs. No. And I figured that one out. Oh, I already knew about it, but oh my god. Is it true or what? Okay, so that should be enough for now. We need to go ahead and craft a couple things. Firstly, we need to craft a furnace. There we go. We've got a furnace. We want to go ahead, shove the iron and shove the coal in there. We don't need coal for anything else currently. We need to make probably an axe to get some wood for us. Cut this tree down whilst our bucket is being, all the materials for our bucket is being created. Once we get this tree down, this tree should be enough wood for us, hopefully. We're not going to use wood for obvious reasons that much for building purposes. We're probably going to use cobblestone for building purposes. Most likely because it's blast proof from ghasts, blasts, and it doesn't burn as wood does. So wood's not the greatest material to use. Okay, take that. Okay, that's just sitting there. Possibly saplings are useful. Although, unless you kill a lot of skeletons, they're not the greatest, the most useful things. Okay. Oh, we've already got some food, other than the stuff we're going to get in the village. That's cool. Oh, okay. I don't even care. I'm running. I know. It's bad. What are you doing? Making it unsafe. Okay. So, I'm going to go ahead and get the obsidian blocks now. Very important. Get this in daytime because it's a pain in the ass to get it in the nighttime. That's a big tip, by the way. I will say use that. That tip is massively recommended because doing it at nighttime, unless you're already there, is a painful experience because skeletons come along, they shoot you from a long distance. Zombies come along and they could have a massive radius of finding you. And then creepers come along and if you're not looking, they blow you up. The first two happened to me, and a spider, but apart from that, not really. The creepers didn't really bother me. Skeletons, though, they're painful. And I had a witch as well. Oh, that cow's burning. I'm not going to use its meat, by the way. I can't. Oh, okay, you're still alive. Good. You're probably on the brink of death, but, you know, don't walk into that fire. Always baffles me. Minecraft mobs are stupid. How much will that be? That'll be 8 or something around that number. Oh, 7. Okay, 7. So we've got 7. 8, 9, 10. We just got 3 more to go. And then we can go ahead, cut some mushrooms down. And then finally, head off to the village to get our spoils from the village. Because we've got some, but we haven't got all. And then I'm going to get the most out of get the most cobblestone we can get. 10. Okay, 10. 10. 10. I'm going to make the portal. Dirt. 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 Oh no, well, I went to put it one too far, damn it. I'm an idiot. Break this. Come on. Break this. That's a cow, because that's a loud, heavy-footed animal. And then finally, this piece of obsidian. See, it gets dark quickly. We're only on our, I think, 12 minutes or so now. It's good. 2-person gap. There we go. So, take this. These gaps. So, have we got any flint? Any gravel? That's a question. No, we haven't got any gravel. That's unfortunate. We need gravel. Gravel's literally everywhere, though. And where's our... Oh, God. Gravel, you're definitely down here. I know you're down here. Oh, hello, Gravel. I just need one of you. I need you to drop me some flint. Oh, there we go. Flint. That was lucky after the third time of breaking it. Okay, we're back up. Hopefully, mobs haven't had the chance to spawn a great deal. Because they really do damage at this state. Ah, oh, there we go. We've already made a bucket, so might as well make some armor. There you go, and then finally this. Made a full set of iron armor. I want to take this. Don't need this for smelting purposes anymore. We probably want to make a sword as well. Compasses don't work in the Nether. Okay, I feel badass now. Okay, this is a lot easier than it was previously. Because I was using a diamond pickaxe to kill mobs in my previous attempt. Which isn't much better. It isn't much worse than a iron sword, but hey. It's an improvement. I'm not going to light the portal just yet. I'm going to go over... I've got a couple things to do, haven't I? Firstly, mushrooms. Go to the mushrooms. Destroy the mushrooms. That's my first priority. Mushrooms. Ah, makes me sound crazy. Do you get more yield out of breaking a mushroom with a axe? That's a question. Maybe you do. Okay. That was much faster than last time. I don't know how many mushrooms we got out of that. But it's all about starting out and how much food we have starting out. It's a fine line between repairing and just, you know, stockpiling food. So we've got 12 mushrooms out of that. That's pretty good. Now we go ahead and go for this red mushroom. Wait, I'm going to go for the... Is there a one over there? This is bad. Okay, well, I'm going to go for either way. It's going to be quite dangerous to go for this one, but either one looks dangerous. Okay. Mine this. Okay. Take this zombie out. That's no point, just hit it with my fist. Probably faster than a sword, actually. Okay, I think that is it. That is all the chances we're going to get with the mushrooms. Okay, that's a fairly good amount of mushrooms per. That'll get us going to start with. Where's the sun? Okay, the sun is going down quickly. Oh, yes, the sun, the moon is going down quickly. When I get here to the village. Quickly get to the village. When I quickly get to the village. Oh, please shut up. Ad block. No, my antiviruses are being annoying. Don't think it's shown up, which is good. Okay, that's the first thing we need to ransack. Next thing we need to ransack. Literally everything. Oh no, 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 no. Like your personal guard. Oh, bones. Very important. Oh my god. Oh, God. Ow, you bloody... I hate skeletons. They're painfully annoying. They are painfully annoying. I'm sorry, cow. My desperation, I harmed you. My desperation of finding stuff. Oh my god. More things over here. Yield still quite high. Good, good, good. Oh my god. Oh, that's everything we're gonna get out of here. Move, cow. I'm gonna eat some food before I keel over and die. Okay. There we go. That's good. It's a rush, isn't it? Okay. Running. Not taking any chances here. This is all the stuff we can get out of the farms. Not taking the seed for reasons I've said previously. I have literally everything on me, including cobblestone. We have ample time compared to what we previously had. Oh my god. Ready? Okay. There we go. We've got some special moment. Okay. Into the Nether now. Into the Nether. And we are... in another. Okay, without delay, break obsidian with pickaxe. Come on, break. There you go. That was a lag. And then I need to get to a point where it definitely will fall in lava. Yep. And of course we got this obsidian block. Goodbye. So we're trapped in another. Oh my god, this is still day zero as well. Still day zero. Or day one. Well, I guess we should go ahead. Make another pickaxe. Make a small base of operations. Coat it in cobblestone so we don't get blown up by ghasts. And thrive in the Nether. Not quite sure how you thrive in the Nether, but hey. It's a nice challenge, isn't it? Okay, so it's day one. Day one. Oh god, this has been an interesting day. I'm going to actually just stop it here and record more later. I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope everyone enjoyed. This was actually a really tense start, but I loved it. I loved the start of it. It was really good, really good. Anyway, in the description, stuff will be there if you want some details. Of course, head over to Michael Deering's channel if you want some more details, and head over to I forgot the name. I'll put the announcement video in the description where I found it anyway. Yeah, so I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll be uploading this on Friday, and I hope you enjoy the next day and etc. if I survive. So yeah, I don't know what else to say. Been an interesting challenge, interesting day one. Anyway, bye!